And then I started to fight, and actually it became my life at that moment. You have to commit for the sport like 100%. And if you don't do, if you're not do it 100%, you will never reach the top.
All right.
Again.
See, it's time to laugh. You've had a laugh day. All right, guys. LDBC, this is your boy, Coach Shelton Harrison. You're live on the Coach Shelton Harrison Combat Sports Show live. And, guys, we got the World Kunlun Kickboxing Champion here again. Here. I can't believe this. And this, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. And, you know, we were just talking, you know, we just kind of talking behind the scenes while I was doing the sound check. And, you know, you was telling me about this opponent, this girl that wanted to fight you. So what's going on? You got an opponent?
Yes. First, there were three opponents for this fight, but nothing was confirmed yet. So I thought, let's give them a name. So I told I just said I wanna maybe I can fight Michaela from Germany, and they said okay, we keep it in mind, we will look for it and blah blah blah. So but it because she was in my mind was because of somebody tagged me on Facebook, and the person who tagged me said yeah, maybe you can fight Michaela. So it was there in my mind, so I thought, okay, we can do it then. So that's how it goes. The rest is history.
Michaela, okay. Hey, Hanissa, I hear you over there using some Americanisms. The rest is history. Okay, that's getting good. You getting good with that. I'm, you know what? Girl, it's going to be epic. Well, I'm going to tell you. Michaela, you know, she's tough, you know. Did a little research, you know. She can bang a little bit, you know. And it is a good opponent, you know. I think it's a good opponent. But, you know, I'm looking at some of the people you done faced. You done faced Jendroba. You done faced Bars. I mean, you know, you done faced Winans. And it's like, okay, I don't know if she knows who she getting in there with.
I think she knows, but maybe she thinks she has a chance. So why not fighting, you know? I fight because I love to fight and I love to win. Some people are love fighting too, but yeah, I don't know. I think I'm more willing to fight and to win than her. And don't get me wrong, every opponent I step into the ring with them, they're all tough. They can get the punch, you know? Mm. So, I think I wanted more. And, and that's my propose. That's one of my proposes here, that I'm here on this earth. Just because of fighting. I got the propose to fight, so.
Well, God has put you on earth then. God put you on earth to fight. When God broke the mold, he broke you. So we got, thank you, right. Lord, for making Hanissa Haddawi. God, thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
And we got Hanissa saying thank you, Lord. God, this is what I'm talking about. This is great. So she's got some experience, you know. She's got some experience. She's got some kickboxing experience. You know, definitely she's going to come to fight. So it's going to be a good fight. Now, what day do you fight? Because I actually, you know, if it's a pay-per-view, I know I'm gonna get the pay-per-view, and some of my followers, they're gonna get the pay-per-view. So, could you tell us, like, Which day are you fighting?
I'm fighting Sunday, March 25th. And it's yeah, it's Dutch time. So I think you have to be 8 hours back.
If you're on the East Coast, like where I'm at, I'm 5 hours behind you. But
Okay,
then,
5 hours. Five
and
hours. Okay. It starts at 2 p.m.
okay.
And you can watch it live on WFL stream.tv. So
Okay.
keep that in mind and tune in when it starts.
Now, folks, I'm gonna have that across the screen, and I'm gonna also do a post-fight analysis video on the fight. I'm gonna break down the fight after you complete it, and then and hopefully when it's all over, you come back and then have you talk about it. But man, guys, don't be cheap. Y'all better go because it's on the screen. Don't say you couldn't hear Nissa. Don't say that, okay? It's gonna be on the screen. You click, and matter of fact, I'm gonna leave a link in the description of this video. So you will go click on that link, and then you're gonna buy this fight because I'm going to get it. I'm gonna talk about it. I don't care what it costs. Anissa Hadawi is fighting. I got to buy this fight. Okay, got to. Got to buy it. So okay, so now with all this, okay, now the last time you actually had any kind of fight action, you took a short notice fight against Antonina Shevchenko. So can you
Yeah,
tell
that's
us?
right.
How have you grown, like, since that fight and then until now? Because you're going back into your bread and butter. You're going back into kickboxing and Muay Thai.
It was a short notice fight, first of all. I had like 2 weeks. I stepped in because she doesn't ha because her opponent pulled out. So I said, yes, why not? And yeah, and she trains with her sister. And her sister is very good. everybody knows. But I tried my best, and yeah, I didn't go well. Didn't go my way, anyways. But yeah, it's a very different game, you know. MMA is like, yeah, it's like you can do more. It is more complete, a more completed game, and I realized after that fight that I'm gonna put the focus on kickboxing, 100%, and how you say it, no distraction from other sports, so I can fully focus on the kickboxing. I can make a lot of excuses in that fight, but I don't because she was the better fighter that night. So. All the credits to her. I think if I'm gonna fight again MMA, I want to be very well prepared for MMA fight. And how do you say it? And it's very hard, by the way, to get an opponent who has the same record as you. And she was like a little compared, but still, she's a Muay Thai fighter, and I'm a K1 fighter. So there's a little difference, you know. It's like if you compare tennis with I don't know, ping pong. That's the same thing.
I like that analogy.
So yeah, that's a little difference. And for me, it's I had like before. I wanted to do a few MMA fights as well, but then maybe five of them they were like potential, but then they didn't want to fight me because of my K1 record. So yeah, for me it's like hard to get someone the same as me, you know? Like the experience with wrestling and on the ground, you know? And so I want to be well prepared if I'm going to do it again. But for now, for this year, it's going to be based on K1, 100%. So no distraction.
Now I know when you say, hey, you ain't got no excuses. Anissa, you took a fight that several people turned down, okay? Several people turned that fight down, and I gotta have y'all know that, okay? Anissa was like, "No problem. Yeah, let's fight." And she took a fight against one of, the more well-rounded fighters in the world. So, that's got to be, and you took it on 2 week notice, okay? So that means that the other disciplines of MMA, you still kind of, you're still exploring those, you still were, but you took a fight anyway. I mean, people don't do that. You're a throwback fighter. You just want to fight. That's it. You
Yeah.
just want to fight. You don't care. I think it could be, it could be a street fight. I can see you just, okay, no problem. Let's do this, girl. Let's go. Like that's why I get excited when I know I'm about to interview you. I get excited. I'm like, yo, she's about to, really, get in this fight, and now this time, you about to get into your bread and butter. So I mean, we're about to see another Nissa Hadawi, like going a whole nother level. I mean,
Yeah, I think so too. It's I think it's funny that you say that you're saying this because in between from the last fight against Antonina Shevchenko till now, I kept on training, and yeah, I think I'm again progressing and still progressing actually. So I wasn't sitting still, or how do you say it? Sitting. I was not. I was doing something, I was working on my fighting skills.
Yeah, I mean, and Anissa, I keep up with you because you always come in my news feed on social media. I don't think you were sitting around eating donuts, but you like to eat, but you don't look like you was eating. You like you was in there, training. Because I would have asked you, hey, you got all these cakes and donuts, hey, Anissa, what's going on, girl? You doing a food binge? But nah, girl, you was in there training. I'm talking about hitting it hard. And Anissa, I don't know. This question coming up to me. I have still yet to find Mike. And since our last talk, I have been trying to find a photo of Mike. I've been trying to find, I cannot find Mike, and this is getting to me.
Oh, okay. I will send you a picture then.
Yeah, 'cause
You
I'm like,
don't see my pictures on Facebook?
but see, I see all of your pictures, but
Yeah.
which one of those guys, who the hell is Mike? I'm trying to like say, I'm trying to say, Mike, you're inspiration. I'm trying to leave the guy just some good comments. Mike at Mike's gym, man. Listen, this is why Nissa Dowie, this is part of the reason why she's successful. The atmosphere at Mike's gym, that's a fighter's gym. I mean, people in there whooping ass all day long. I mean,
Yeah, that's true because a lot of glory fighters are from Mike's gym as well, and they're good as well, and we make each other better to yeah to get as well prepared for a fight, even better than a fight maybe. Beating each other up, but sometimes you need a beat up because yeah, you want to get better,
yeah, well, I have no doubt that you're better. I mean, even in some of your footages that you allow us to see, you're looking a lot sharper. You're looking real sharp. Like, you just look like that you can close your eyes and fight, and you would actually start moving around, and you'd be able to dodge and do everything. That's how sharp you're looking. And it appear like you made weight relatively easy, right?
Yeah, that's right. No
Okay.
struggling.
Now, what's the first
I
thing you
mean,
okay.
it's a part of the fight game, So you have to be dedicated as well with the weight and how you treat your body,
Yeah, well,
That's one of the things you have to take care as well. It's
you
not always fight. It's always training, but it's not always training,
Well, you seem like you're a woman who treats somebody well. And I gotta ask you, what's the first thing you're gonna eat at the weigh-ins?
Sorry, again?
So, what's the first thing that you're gonna eat after the weigh-ins, when you're able to actually take in, something, a little bit more, I guess, fulfilling.
Oh, I am gonna get a pasta.
You're gonna get some pasta.
Yes, that's
Now,
right.
is your lovely mother gonna make this pasta for you, or are you gonna go buy it?
No, I'm gonna let my mom cook for me then.
Really? Okay.
I didn't ask her yet, but I'm gonna ask her. But she will do it for me.
Well,
Yeah.
mom might be a little busy. She might just say, well, no. I mean,
Yeah, no, yeah, that's right.
okay. Nah, she's not gonna tell, she's not gonna tell her special baby no. She's not gonna tell you no, okay? But
No.
could you tell mom to, make a vegan version and give some of that to the coach?
A vegan burger?
Nah, could you tell mom to make a vegan pasta and give some of that to the coach?
Okay.
Nah, she's not gonna do that. But hey, it was worth a try, But it's probably gonna look delicious. Okay, so
Yeah.
I also learned too. You actually got a white belt in BJJ, right?
I got what?
Did you just recently get your white belt in BJJ?
No, I have a blue belt.
Got a blue belt. I'm sorry, girl. You moving up in the world? Like what? A
You
blue belt.
didn't do your homework.
I did. I actually did
No,
enough homework.
I'm just kidding. Yeah, I have a blue
Look
belt in BJJ.
at this. Anissa throwing me under the bus. You worse than Eric. You worse than my co-partner Eric. It's just so much fun. I'm choked up over this. I'm coughing now because of you. Thank you.
Yeah, of course. I would do the same.
That's okay. That's okay. God bless you. That's okay. I got you. I got you. No worries. Well, that's.
God bless you
That's still good though. That's still good. So you're progressing. Okay, listen. I just want to know, will we ever see Anissa Hadawi in an octagon or in an MMA environment again?
too. I don't know. I
Okay. She.
don't know. I cannot look into the future. So
Yeah, she
I
took
will
it.
leave it like there, like that, and then we will see what the future will bring me.
Y'all, she took a deep breath too when she said that. She took a deep breath. She's like, I don't know. Hey, I get it, 'cause you got other fighters too that you guys are really, really focused on your kickboxing and Muay Thai skills, and you guys want to promote that. So, I
Yes.
understand, 'cause you and fighters like Bars, you and fighters like Winans, you guys and Jendrover. You guys are fighting, trying to really promote your sport. This is your sport, So, and you got people like Denise Kilhose, who's, they do MMA, but at heart they're kickboxers, That's what they are.
Yeah.
Do you think, because with your resume, girl, you got over 40 fights. First of all, you got over 40 wins in kickboxing. Can you just tell people how hard that is to do, like on any level?
How hard it is.
40 fights. You got over 40
Level.
victories.
I will give it an eight.
It's hard to do, and there are not a lot of 40 fighter win people in women's Muay Thai and kickboxing, because I've checked. Okay,
Yeah.
that's not a whole lot of y'all. You are in a fraternity, and here in America, fraternity, it's a thing, a club that they have at college. You're in small company. Do you see like a place like Bellator, actually saying, okay, Anissa, we want your skill sets, okay? Come, be a part of this. Let's go.
Yeah, I will say yes, of course. Let's do it.
Okay then.
But the one thing I don't understand is, maybe I understand, but the interest is so big into MMA instead of kickboxing. But still, with the Bellator kickboxing, it's still not that popular as MMA. Do you know what's the reason of this?
Why it's not.
Because everyone,
Oh, go ahead. I'm
yeah,
sorry.
because everyone wants to see somebody punch each other in the face, you know? And with kickboxing, we do the same, but it's not that brutal as MMA.
Okay. Yeah. So, okay. I know what you're saying. You're saying that people want to see a bunch of blood and guts and,
Yeah.
blood spilled all over the octagon. And, people want to see that. They do. Some people do. But then too, we can think about this. The highest paid combat athlete ever is a Floyd Mayweather Jr. and he was a stylistic fighter. I think one day, and you're young enough. Jermaine Barnes is young enough. Denise Kilhose, you guys are young enough to, continue to bring attention to the sport because, you guys conduct yourselves with confidence. And I know you're not afraid of anybody. And you just go in there and you guys fight tough fights. And I really hope and pray that one day that some of these fights, they'll become legendary fights that people will just keep looking at and, have a high demand for it. And then, too, you guys are, you guys are not, as one of the fighters I've interviewed before, she said, they want us to go in there. They want us to look like little whores in the ring. But, we're fighters. We got skill sets, You guys are athletes. You guys are well-conditioned athletes. And I think the public's going to want to see that, the skill.
Yeah, that's eventually where it's what it's about, the skills.
I hope though. You've been in enough fights though. You've had enough fights to where your skill set, your fights, your resume, your attitude. I mean, I don't know if there's anybody that you got coming up that's fighting you next. I don't think there's anybody else who could actually take you down. I don't know. I mean, who's left?
Yeah, right.
I mean, have you asked yourself that? Like, who's left?
Yeah, there's still people left. So still working,
Okay.
I'm still getting better every day. And we're going to see it on Sunday, of course. Then it's time to show people what I have. What I more have in how you say it, in how do you say it? How I grew more in the maybe in 5 months. So
five months.
I'm very excited about it.
In 5 months, and this, you're gonna be putting people to sleep. I'm talking about putting them to sleep when you hit them.
Right.
You're gonna be tearing them up. But man, this fight is gonna be good. Okay, guys, don't try to pirate the fight. Don't pirate the fight. Don't stream the fight, guys. Click on the link. Okay, go to it. Okay, go to the fight. Okay, buy the fight. I'm gonna buy the fight. Okay, don't care what it costs. Nissa's doing a thing. I'm gonna go to the fight. I'm gonna buy the fight, and then I'm gonna watch the fight, and then I'm gonna show my support in this fight. This is gonna be a good fight. It's gonna be a good fight. There's not somebody that Anissa is just gonna go in there and just do. No, Anissa's gonna show the skills, guys. You're gonna see this woman, okay, Coonlin, okay, Coonlin champion. I don't even know if you guys understand what that means. When I started researching that, I'm like, wow, it's not a whole lot of people that's become a Coonlin champion. Not like a lot.
Yeah, that's right. Especially the European people. Because I'm the first female European who won a title, who became a champion in Kunlun. So it doesn't happen that much. It's very rare, I will say.
Oh, and this, I done my homework. Throw me under the bus, baby. Throw me under the bus. I got you. I got you, Anissa Hadawi. But guys, this is going to be a beautiful fight. You're going to see the best of the best. And if you've ever watched an Anissa Hadawi fight, guys, it is a thing of beauty. Her technique, her martial arts, the way, she actually executes her offense, even her defense. It's a thing of beauty to watch this woman fight. I can't say girl.
Oh, and by the way, yes. I'm also the first Moroccan who won the Moulin Championship. So that's something rare as well.
See that? A double. She's double. The first Moroccan. The first Moroccan to win, the European. Hey, y'all can tell she's Moroccan because, she's kind of a little feisty, She's got some of those Moroccan tendencies to get a little feisty, That's okay. That's okay. Hey, well, listen, I always have fun. I have fun when I talk to you. I have a lot of fun. Hey, anybody you want to, say hey to, you want to shout out? What you got?
Oh, I want to do a shout out to all my Moroccan people. And of course, all the American people who don't know me.
So you gonna say the
I'm sorry.
Moroccan people for okay, I got it. I got it. Nah, that's okay.
Maybe we have Moroccan people in America. I don't know. Maybe they know me.
See?
But anyways, I want to do a shout out for all my people who support me and who is part of my journey and who helps me every day. And with every fight, to prepare myself at a, for a fight. And I want to thank you because you want to take time to get an interview, a short interview before my fight. Yeah, that's it.
You just don't know. I'm elated to talk to you. Do you know I would probably faint if I took a photograph with you. That's I'm like, you don't get it. I'm talking to you. Like I watched you in those fights, man. See, you just don't get it. I'm talking to you. Had to take a couple of deep breaths, I did took a couple of deep breaths. I'm talking to Anissa Hadawi. Like this is great. Wow. This is awesome. This is extremely awesome, but I'm thankful to you because I know your fight schedule. Everybody. A lot of people want to interview you. People are beating you, and it's like you took time to interview with me. So I'm like, thank you, man. This is much respect to you. Much respect. Respect to your
Thank you.
mom, and tell your mom that Coach. I don't think you told your mom Coach Shelton Harrison said hey last time. I think you forgot.
No, I told you, told my mom.
Okay. Oh, so what did she
So
say?
she said, "Oh, that's funny. And who is that guy? Where is he from? Blah, blah, blah." So she was interested.
Tell your mom, how is she gonna explain this? And see, and tell you, I remember your mom. Tell your mom, congratulations on the new house. Yeah, you know what? But
Oh, thank you.
you know.
Yeah, she's like 100%, yeah, like how you say it, acclimated, or how do you say it?
Yeah, acclimated
Yeah.
into her new house.
Okay.
That's
Okay. Yeah,
okay.
and it's very nice. It's very very comfortable.
I bet it is, and I bet you go over there. You're gonna get your nice little pasta dish, and you're gonna run, play with the dog a little bit, and then you're gonna beat some, gonna beat up some people. That's good. That's gonna work out.
Yes, that's right. Sounds like a good plan.
Well, guys, on behalf of Hanessa Hadawi, okay, Hanessa Hadawi, the Moroccan-born European, only time kick coolin', okay, it man, it just don't get no better than Hanessa Hadawi. This is Coach Shelton Harrison. I'm done. And Anissa, just say bye to all your new fans or,
Bye, America.
I was waiting. I was hoping you say America. That's how she say, guys, us Americans.